My name is Linda Nassif, and like many mature women in the third stage of their lives, my main focus was on my children and grandchildren. Of course, all healthy, beautiful, strong, with parents that gave them love, attention, and time, and sent them to the best schools so they would have unlimited possibilities in the future. But though the proudest of mothers and grandmothers, I often felt empty and self-absorbed. So one day while searching the net, I came across a site called The Cultural Explorer, which was designed to take adventurous women to South Africa to volunteer to work and empower and teach the resilient orphans and Zulu women. I wasn't sure what I had to offer, although I was a speaker and a psychologist, but I hoped when I got there, the answers would come. Well, it turned out that they were the ones that empowered me and taught me about true resilience, true hope, true courage, and true unconditional love, and changed my life forever. We have learned to smile more, even if our hearts are suffering. We have learned to dance hard. When we're happy. Sisani asked us, what do we do in America when we're happy? And we were like, I don't know. Now we know what to do when we're happy. We will dance and sing like our Zulu sisters. Never again, I don't think, will we walk into a room and have all of these beautiful women and men greet us with and you say, as I take my beautiful turban home with me. And people will ask me, what are you wearing? And I will say, I am a Zulu woman.
Siten Sidi Basamane.
hard to imagine that there is still a place in the world where women are treated like a commodity that can be bought and sold. Meet Sisani Gubane, often called the female Nelson Mandela, and my friend.
It's like, for most men, I'm sorry, it's like, she's my wife, I paid Ilobolo for her, she's my property. And when he passed on, the male relatives, our brother paid Ilobolo for her, she is our property. We could treat her like a commodity that could be sold and bought, not like a human being. So their expectation is that if the brother passes away, they can go and inherit it as part of the family's property. Her husband passed on in 2009.
Yes.
And as a pretty in the community, she is expected to be inherited by one of her brother-in-law.
You mean they give her? They inherit her?
Her as an individual. They forced her into an arranged marriage. And she's resisting that. And as in-law, culturally, they are supposed to be providing for her as a widow. She is saying she does not want their money because they come knocking at her door at night. They expect to force her into an arranged marriage, and she does not agree with the practice. It's a harmful practice, and she doesn't want to happen to her.
It's hard to imagine that there's still a place in the world where men rape children, babies, the aged, without any legal consequences. Meet Mama Cecilia, our equivalent of a social worker, but so very much more.
This is the child sent this child to me. With the gogo. The gogo is crying. Crying. So I started to ask Cynthia, the little one, what happened to you? Oh. I said the gogo is supposed to cry. Three men were raping you.
Oh.
The home based carer found that the child was raped by the father. The mother died. And the child went back to the grandmother. When the child is going to school, the father will call the child to another house and rape the child.
Why was he not punished?
They changed the statement. And the child, they changed the statement, saying, told the child, you must never say that your father has raped you. Go and say, I was lying.
What?
Go and say, I was lying.
Who was telling her this?
Yeah.
The granny.
The granny?
The aunt.
The aunt.
Yeah. Of the husband?
Yes.
So,
why?
So that the father can come out from jail. Cried and cried and cried and cried. Later, then she told me the story. What's gonna happen to me? Stop it now. Please, I don't want this thing to go out. Tell me, how are you going to help me to heal my heart? I said, your heart won't be healed. It's gonna be pain forever.
A place where women have no rights, and a widow's property, and even her children, can be confiscated if she doesn't acquiesce to the in-laws' demands.